Hi students, welcome to Vidyanagar online classes. Today we are going to discuss a new topic, that is three-dimensional shapes. Till now we have discussed about two-dimensional shapes like triangles, quadrilaterals and all. Now we are going to discuss about three-dimensional shapes. So see here, these all are three-dimensional shapes. First one is cube, okay? And the example for cube, you can take a plane die. Plane die is in the shape of a cube, okay? Then the second one is cuboid. It is also a three-dimensional shape. And the best example for cuboid, you can take a matchbox. Matchbox is in the shape of a cuboid. Then the third one is cone. It is also a 3D shape, three-dimensional shape. And the best example you can take for the cone is ice cream. Ice cream cones, you might have seen. They are in the shape of cones. Birthday caps are also in the shape of the cones. Okay. Now the fourth one is cylinder. Okay, this is a cylinder. It is also a 3D shape. For example, you can take pipe. Pipe is in the shape of the cylinder. Okay, then fifth one is sphere. Okay, this is the shape of the sphere. It is also a three-dimensional shape. And football and all other balls are the examples of sphere. They all are in the shape of the sphere. And the last one is pyramid. This is the shape of pyramid. As you look in the picture, this chocolate box is in the shape of the pyramid. So these all are the three-dimensional shapes, okay, cube, cuboid, cone, cylinder, sphere, pyramid, they all are the three-dimensional shapes, okay. So now let us discuss about the faces, edges and vertices. So let us talk about faces, edges and vertices with the help of a cube, okay. So first of all, let us see faces. So what are faces? Faces are single flat surfaces. See, this is a cube and flat surfaces, see this one is the flat surface and one flat surface will be at the back side, okay. Back side also one flat surface will be there. One flat surface will be at upside, okay. And one will be at downside. So these all are faces and one face will be at the right side, this side, and one will be at the left side. So these all are the flat surfaces and these all are the faces. Suppose you look at this box, okay, this box. And what are its faces? Flat surfaces are the faces. So see here, this one is the face, okay. This one is also the face. This is also the face. This is also the face downside. One, this upside is also the face. And this backside is also the face. So these all are the faces. What are faces? Faces are the flat surfaces, okay. Now let us talk about edges, okay. What is an edge? A line segment between two faces is called edge. Okay, see here, these line segments, this is an edge, this is an edge. Okay, all the line segments which joins two faces, okay, they are the edges. Okay, if you look at this box, see here, so what are its edges? This line segment, this line segment, this line segment, this one, this one, this one, all the line segments between two faces are the edges, okay. Now let us talk about the vertices. What are the vertices? Vertices are the corners where edges meet. So see here, what are the corners? This one, this is a vertex, this is also a vertex, then this is also a vertex, this is also a vertex, all the corners where edges meet. This is also a vertex, this is also a vertex, and this is also a vertex. If you look at this box, see here, what are its vertices? See here, first one is this one, corner, this corner, this corner, this corner, like this, this one also, this also, they all are vertices. So what are vertices? Vertices are the corners where the edges meet. Okay, so that's all about the faces, edges and vertices. Now we are going to do our exercise, that is exercise 5.9. See the second question of the exercise. What is the second question? What shape is A part is your instrument box? You might have seen the instrument box. It is in the shape of the cuboid. Okay. What is the shape of your instrument box? Yes, it is in the shape of cuboid. Now the B part is a brick. Brick is also in the shape of the cuboid. Brick is also in the shape of cuboid. Now C part is matchbox. I have already told you that matchbox is in the shape of the cuboid. Okay, it is also cuboid. Then D part are road roller. Okay, if you have seen the road roller, it is in the shape of the cylinder. Okay, so road roller, it is in the shape of the cylinder. And then the last part is a sweet laddu. You all know the sweet laddu is in the shape of the sphere. Yes, sphere. Okay, so that is all about the second question. So now our fifth chapter is completed. Now we are going to start a new chapter, that is chapter number 6, integers. Okay, integers. Before introducing about integers, I want to ask you, do you know what are natural numbers? Yes, natural numbers means numbers starting from 1. Like see here, 1, 2, 3, and like this they go on. They all are natural numbers. The counting numbers are called natural numbers. The numbers starting from 1. Okay? Then what are whole numbers? Yes, if we add 0 to this natural number, then we will get whole numbers. Suppose you add 0 to these numbers, 0, 1, 2, 3, and it goes on like this. So they all are whole numbers if we add 0 to the natural numbers. Now what is an integer? In integer, we add one more group of numbers to the whole numbers. And that group of numbers is negative numbers. If we add negative number to these whole numbers, then we will get integers. What are the negative numbers? The numbers having negative sign on them. Suppose minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, like this they goes on. Okay. So the collection of negative numbers and whole numbers are called integers. Okay. What is an integer? The collection of negative numbers and the whole numbers. Can you give me some examples of integers? Yes, minus 10. Yes, very good. It is also an integer. Minus 9. It is also an integer. 0. It is also an integer. 5. Yes, it is also an integer. 100. It is also an integer. So they all are integers. Collection of whole numbers and negative numbers are known as integers. Okay. Now let us discuss how to represent integers on the number line. So see here, this is the number line. If you see here, 0 is at the middle, okay? And at the right side of the 0, positive numbers are here. See, at the right side of the 0, positive integers are here. And at the left side of the 0, negative integers are here, okay? Now if you want to represent 3 on the number line, so 3 is a positive integer or positive number. So where will be 3? Yes, 3 will be at the right side of the 0. So just 3 is here. You can circle this number. So in this way, you can represent any integer on the number line. Now suppose you want to represent minus 4 on the number line. So where will be minus 4? Yes, since minus 4 is negative integer, it will be at the left side of the 0. So what is the left side of the 0? This side. Where is minus 4? Here. So you can circle this integer. In this way, you can represent any integer on the number line. Okay. Now if I ask you which integer is greater, suppose two integers are given to you, one is minus 3 and other one is minus 4. Now I ask you which integer is greater. So you see here, minus 4 is this one, minus 3 is this one. Which integer is at the right side? Yes, minus 3 is at the right side of minus 4. So, minus 3 is greater than minus 4. Understood? The integer which is at the right side in the number line is greater. Okay? Now, if I ask you, which integer is greater, minus 2 or minus 1? Which integer is greater? Yes, minus 1. Why? Because minus 1 is at the right side of minus 2. So in this way, you can tell which integer is greater. You can compare the integers. Okay? Any problem? Now let us see where we use positive numbers and where we use negative numbers. Okay? Suppose you are depositing the money in the bank. That means you are getting profit. the amount is increasing in your account, at that time we will represent it by positive number. Okay, this is positive. Now if you are withdrawing the money, you are taking the money from the bank, that means the amount is decreasing in your account, at that time we will represent it by negative number. See, this is negative if you are withdrawing the money. Now if the height is above the ground level, okay, then it will be represented by positive number, and if the height is below the ground level, then it will be represented by negative numbers. Okay, then if the temperature is above 0 degree Celsius, above 0 degree Celsius, then it will be represented by positive numbers. If the temperature is below 0 degree Celsius, then it will be represented by negative numbers. So in all these places we use positive numbers and negative numbers in our day to day life. Okay, now we are moving to our exercise 6.1. see, what is the first question? Write opposite to the following. We have to write the opposite to these following. Okay, see the A part, increase in weight. What will be its opposite? Yes, decrease in weight. Decrease in weight. Okay, now B part, 30 km north. We have to write the opposite of it. So it will be 30 km south. Okay, 30 km south. Now C part, 326 BC. What will be its opposite? Yes, 326 AD. Okay, now E part, 100 meter above sea level. What will be its opposite? Yes, 100 meter below sea level. Okay, so these all are the opposites. Now let us do the second question. What is the second question? Represent the following numbers as integers with appropriate signs. Okay, we have to represent the numbers as integers with their appropriate sign, whether positive sign will come or negative sign. Let us see the A part. What is the A part? An aeroplane is flying at a height 2000 meter above the ground. Above the ground means positive sign, so it will be plus 2000 meter. Okay, see, since it is given above the ground, so it will be positive 2000 meter, plus 2000 meter. Now see the B part. A submarine is moving at a depth 800 meter below the sea level. Below, it is given below the sea level, so it will be negative. So the answer will be minus 800 meter. See, it is given 800 meter below, so it will be minus 800 meter. Understood? Now let us do the C part of the same question. What is the C part? A deposit of rupees 200. That means you are depositing money, you are getting profit. So it will be positive. Positive plus 200 rupees. Okay, plus 200 rupees. Now D part, withdrawal of rupees 700. You are taking the money from the bank. That means the amount is decreasing in your account. Then we will represent it by negative sign. So it will be minus 700 rupees. Okay. Now let us do the third question. See, what is the third question? Represent the following numbers on a number line. We are given the numbers and we have to represent the numbers on the number line. First part is, A part is plus 5. We have to represent plus 5 on the number line. So first of all, we will draw the number line. See here. Okay, and at the middle of the number line will be 0. 0 will be here. Okay, and at the right side of 0 will be positive number. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like this. All the positive numbers will be there at the right side of the 0. And at the left side of the 0, there will be negative numbers. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, like this. Negative numbers will be there at the left side of the 0. Now we want to represent plus 5. So where will be the plus 5? Yes, plus 5 will be at the right side of the 0, since it is a positive number. So we can represent it by circle. This is the representation of plus 5 on the number line. Now let us do the E part. See, what is the E part? we have to represent minus 6 on a number line. Okay, so first of all, we will draw the number line. 0 will be at the middle. This is 0. And then positive numbers will be at the right side of the 0 and negative numbers will be at the left side. So 1 will be here, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like this. Positive numbers will be at the right side. Now negative numbers at the left side. So minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6. So negative numbers will be at the left side of the 0. Now we want to represent minus 6 on the number line. So see, minus 6 is a negative number. So it will be at the left side of the 0, this side. So where is minus 6? Here. So we can circle it. So this is the representation of minus 6 on a number line. Now we are going to do the fourth question. See what is the fourth question. Adjacent figure is a vertical number line. This vertical number line is given to us representing integer. This is representing the integers. Observe it and locate the following points. We have to locate the following points. So see what is the A part. If point D is plus 8, see here point D is plus 8, then which point is minus 8? We have to tell which point is minus 8. So since it is plus 8, this point will be plus 7, this will be plus 6, this will be plus 5, this will be plus 4, this point will be plus 3, this will be plus 2, this will be plus 1, this will be 0, okay? And this will be minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, minus 7, minus 8. So which point is minus 8? You can see from here, F is minus 8. So we can write F, okay? Now moving to the B part. Is point G a negative integer or positive integer? You can clearly see from here, G is minus 6, so it is negative integer. G is, you can write, negative integer. Okay? Now we are going to do the C part of the same question. See what is the C part? Write integers for B and E. First of all, we will write the integer for B. See here, B is here. What is the integer for B? Plus 4. So B is equal to plus 4. Now what is the integer for E? Where is E? E is here. Since F is minus 8, so this point will be minus 9 and E will be minus 10. So E is equal to minus 10. Now moving to the D part. Which point mark on number line has the least value? Which is having the least value? You can see clearly from here that E is having the least value, that is equal to minus 10. So which point? E. Okay. Now we are going to do the E part. See what is the E part. Arrange all points in decreasing order of value. Decreasing order means from largest to smallest. Okay. So which point has the largest value? Yes, D. So first D, after D, C, after C, B, then A, after A, O, after O is H, and after H is G, after G, F, and which point has the smallest value? Yes, E has the least value. So this is the decreasing order of all the points according to their values. Okay? Okay, so that's all in today's class. We will meet in the next class. Thank you.